Wow, I wonder what could be in this box. Oh, it's a crappy helmet I bought on eBay for like $7. But after just a few satisfying time lapses, this helmet will start to look like it's ready for battle again. The first step in restoring this helmet was to remove the straps. They weren't the correct World War II style straps, and I plan on replacing them with ones from J. Murray Inc. After that, I rubbed this pink stuff called naval jelly all over the helmet to remove the rust and paint. After I scraped that off, it looked okay, but it still needed another coat to get all the rust. After that, the helmet still had a little bit of paint on it, but it was bare enough that I could move on to priming. I sprayed a self-etching primer all over the helmet. This is to stop the rust and act as a base coat, but this won't be the final color of the helmet. After that, the helmet was finally looking like, well, a helmet, and now it just needed to be textured and painted. In World War II, helmets had ground cork sprinkled on them to give them a texture. I tried to grind my cork myself, and boy, was that a mistake. It was not the right texture at all. After that, I started painting the helmet by hand, and I even put on some of that cork I made, but it just didn't look right. This is where I took a pause and ended up getting some real supplies from J. Murray Inc. 1944. They're experts at helmet restoration, and they were nice enough to send me some of their supplies. I'll be using those to finish my helmet soon, but in the meantime, you should go to their website through my bio and look at their helmet selection. They have all kinds of great deals on different helmets, and you can get 15% off with the code WWW15.